Verse 3, listen to him. He's talking about human cannibals who also eat the flesh of my people and flay their skin from them, and they break their bones and chop them in pieces as for the pot and like flesh within the cauldron. In other words, no feeling enters into the judgment at all. No high principle, no character that enters into it. May I say to you that a godless man is the last person that I want to sit in judgment on me on anything. And very frankly, I'm thankful that I don't have to stand before you in judgment, even if you're a Christian today. And you ought to be delighted that you're not going to have to stand before me in judgment. I'm of the opinion that I'm going to come off better in the presence of the Lord Jesus Christ than I'm going to come off in the presence of mankind. And so I appeal my case. My case has already been appealed to him. And I'm not before you today for judgment. And you are not before me today in judgment. And how wonderful that is, by the way, to know that. Now, he says, verse 4, then shall they cry unto the Lord, but he'll not hear them. Who is he talking about? About these leaders. Now, long as they're in a high position, and they have no regard for the human side, there's no real sympathy, no real love. And they're in trouble because a power greater than they are has come down upon them. Then shall they cry unto the Lord, but he'll not hear them. God says, I'll let the judgment come upon you. He will even hide his face from them at that time as they have behaved themselves ill in their doings. God says, now they're going to cry to me. And isn't that interesting? We all cry out to God in time of real trouble. I've been rather amused, and ought not to be, but I can't help but be amused when I hear today the trouble that has come to us. And every now and then somebody says, may God help us. Well, finally God got in the door. I thought they'd bowed him out of his universe. He hasn't been mentioned much except in profanity, but now I find people are saying today, may God help us. Well, my friend, I don't know whether he's going to hear you or not, because he said to these people who had ignored him and had been godless and had turned their back upon God and had lived godless lives, yet they were sitting in judgment on other people, and they had ground down the people because they're not capable. Oh, I don't care whether they graduated from Harvard Law School, that doesn't mean anything. In fact, that could make the worst kind of a judge or the worst kind of a person to sit into a high position, because he'd be clever, but he'd still love evil. Therefore, today, my friend, we need men and women who have a heart, who have more than just cleverness with the law. We need men and women today who, I think, know God. Because when trouble comes, God has certainly not promised to hear them. And he told his people then, when you cry unto me, he'll not hear them. He'll even hide his face from them at that time as they have behaved themselves ill in their doings. God says, I'm going to hide my face from you. And believe me, it looks like he's not doing very much about the situation in the world today. We are in the period of the silence of God, but his grace is still abundant. He's rich in mercy, rich in grace to those who will bow before him and come and accept his Son as Savior.